Sunflower Squad, welcome back to another video. So today we will be baking. I'm gonna show you guys how to make your own Reese's Pieces peanut butter cups. So first, I wanted to tell you guys why we haven't been very active lately. We haven't had many video ideas or anything, so we're trying to get back into it. We've been making shorts, and I just wanted to make a video. And I thought baking was a good day because I'm home alone right now, so nothing else to do. So this is you don't need a stove or anything. You just need a few ingredients to make your Reese's Pieces mini peanut butter cups. Ready? Let's get started. So these are the ingredients that you are going to need. So first, you're gonna need some water. You don't really need to measure this just when you're putting it in there. We're gonna get some ground cinnamon if you want. And then we're also gonna get some cocoa powder. And you're gonna need some peanut butter. It can be crunchy or creamy. I have crunchy, so we're gonna use that. And then you're gonna need some powdered sugar. And I'm using some breakfast essentials. So let's get started. Oh, also you're gonna need a bowl and a pizza pan to put them on. Let's get started. Okay, so first we are going to start by using a spoon. Let's get a measuring cup. 1 second. So we're gonna use these. Okay guys, let's be starting with the breakfast essentials. Sorry if it's loud, my sister's eating popcorn. Okay, so you're gonna use 1 tablespoon of the breakfast essentials. We're gonna start, let's do 2. You're gonna need 2 tablespoons of breakfast essentials. Okay. Now we are going to use some cocoa powder. You don't want too much cocoa powder because it's not very sweet. So we're gonna use, make sure you guys get it to the exact length. Okay. 1 teaspoon cocoa powder. We're gonna use 2 teaspoons of cocoa powder. And it should look like that. Okay, I gotta pick that up. And I'm using, so all my stuff that I need to use is on this side. All my stuff that I'm not using anymore is on this side. That way you guys don't get mixed up. Okay, now we are going to put in some cinnamon. You're not gonna put that much because you don't want it just tasting like cinnamon. So maybe about 1 cup, just a little bit, that way you don't, it's not overpowering. Okay, now I'm gonna put a little bit of peanut butter. It might be a bit sticky, that's why you need some water and stuff. Okay, I'm gonna need a spoon to help me get this out, or a fork, I guess. Gonna use a little more. So it should look like that so far. Okay, now we're gonna need, let's use a spoon to kind of dab it in our mixture. Kind of want to break the peanut butter in it. You guys seen Encanto? Okay, now it should look like that. Now we're gonna use a little bit of water. Now you're gonna mix that in. I'm gonna try and do it like that TikToker where it's water. Perfect. You know that one, guys? Alright, so starting to mix it in. You're gonna need some more stuff just to make it to where you can roll it into balls and put it on your pizza pan. Alright. Now we're gonna break down the peanut butter. Starting to kind of look like brownie mixture. Now we're gonna add a little bit more of the breakfast essentials and peanut butter. because Reese's Pieces are just practically chocolate and peanut butter. Also not sponsored. I just wanted to try this because my family loves Reese's Pieces. And this is a no bake, so you don't need your oven or anything. All you need is a few ingredients for fun. Now we're gonna put another tablespoon of peanut butter. Try and mix that in so it's. You gotta get it kind of like a dough, like a thick dough. That way you can roll it into bowls. You put peanut butter in between it and make your Reese's peanut butter cups.
I got some music.
I'm gonna listen to some music while we bake. Also, I put another. What is this one? Let me check. A teaspoon of cocoa powder. It's starting to thicken up. I should go watch our TikTok with that song. It's looking pretty good, guys. I'm gonna put some more of this and cocoa powder in it. Alright guys, I put some more cocoa powder and breakfast essentials in it, starting to thicken it. You gotta mix this in really well. I don't think you guys need any more water. You guys heard this song before? Also, if you have one here like me, you might want to put it up for when you are about to roll it into balls and put it on your baking sheet so you don't get any hair on it. That's gross. You can add a little bit more cinnamon. Alright guys, now we're going to use our powdered sugar. Measure it to how, like if yours is like mine, I'm going to put quite a bit because you can't have it like running. You got to have it like a dough. So. Yeah, that was kind of juicy. That's fine. We should have named our YouTube channel the Cringe Fam, but somebody else already has that name, so we can. Put that, it looks like snow. Kind of looks like a chocolate souffle. Comment down below if you guys know the song and know how to rap this entire part. See guys, starting to get a bit thick, but you can't have it running off a spoon. So you need to just add more of all your ingredients. I don't think I'm gonna use any more peanut butter, because I'll roll it in the middle. If you're like me, you spin your bowl.
Yeah.
Guys, sorry. You're gonna put some more cocoa powder. As well as some breakfast essentials. Mix it up and see where you have it. If you need more condensed or powdered sugar, put that in. But it's still kind of runny, so And if it just doesn't thicken up, then just keep adding stuff. It will eventually thicken up. So now we're going to put that cocoa powder. Alright guys, so we're almost done. We just need some... a lot of powdered sugar, like a lot. Alright guys, it's starting to form a dough. You can see it because when I mix, it like forms a dough by itself. And once you think it's thick enough, you gotta try your dough and make sure it's good. Starting to get pretty thick. So almost done. Alright guys, so I'm gonna add some more powdered sugar. Okay. Looking pretty good. Okay guys, so what you're gonna do now, I'll flip my camera over here, it's a little messy, sorry guys. So first, we're gonna start by putting some powdered sugar on your pan. Okay guys, put a good amount. Then we're gonna spread it. Make sure to wash your hands, guys. Okay guys. Okay. Now you're gonna wash your hands. Or just get all that stuff off your hand. Okay. So now your pan should look like this. And if yours isn't thickening up, because mine's not, and I don't want it overpowering and super, super, super sweet. So, what I'm going to do to try and save this, because it'll still taste really good, it just won't be in the peanut butter cups, like the cup parts. So, we're going to take some more peanut butter, put it in the batch, alright? And we're going to make peanut butter drizzles. Guys, so now I got this bag and we're gonna put our recipe in this bag and drizzle it like this on top of our powdered sugar, that way it doesn't stick. Or you're gonna have Reese's Pieces drizzle. So it's gonna be a little hard to get in the bag, but it'll work. We can always scoot it down as we go.
We are going to eat this. Not wasting it.
So I'm going to time lapse me putting all the chocolate in the bag. Alright guys, so I put them in little stripes, and now we're going to put it in the freezer, and I'll see you guys in about 2 hours. You guys have it. Super good and delicious.